So these paints, this is a sunflower kit for fabric and art paintings. This has 10 shades. The red one, then there's olive green, and this is white. This is really pretty white and really bright. And then there's burnt sienna again. We have yellow, lemon yellow. Then there's light green. There's orange. Yeah, we don't have to buy orange separately here because they give it in this kit. And then there's deep bill purple and ultramarine blue and black. So this is the sunflower kit in which you get all the bright colors. So here we are done with this. Then I have these Camlin charcoal pencils. These have three types: hard, medium, and soft, for different types of paintings. And then here I have glass paints. I love these glass paints. So we get this glass liner. This has a really nice tip, so you can work with it really nicely. Here. So yeah, and then there's the actual small refill. Then there's yellow, then there's blue, horizon blue, there's moss green, here's coffee brown. We have red. These are really nice. The consistency is really nice. They are solvent based, so they are liquids, like you can see here. This is the medium, which helps you to make the colors light and all. And these have a really good smell. So yeah, so it's just normal glass paints, but I prefer them over the gel based ones. And here I have color pencils. These are nothing new. These have 24 shades here, and these are nice wooden pencils, nice wooden shade. You can actually feel it when you hold it. So like these are a little rough, but these are really good. And the colors are also not very light, they are dark. The grip is also very good. So yeah, and then here we have the plastic crayons. It's not open yet, but I've been using these a lot, and these are really good for simple coloring over the paints, for which where you put the detailing work, like after you finish painting, we color with these shades, so that it appears to be more realistic. And these are the artistic crayons with a sharpener. And then there are shading pencils. These are also the ones you get easily in any store: HB, 2B, 4B, 6B, and 8B for different types of shades. And yes, that's it. So I hope you liked my video, and I hope you got some help with my recommendations. Let's now rate all these. So for oil pastels, out of 10, I will give them 8 or 9, because the pack is really big. I know they could not help it, but still. And the starting grip, when you open this new pack and start it, you first have to rub it before you actually start coloring, because the strokes come really straight and not very good. So because these are like circles, like perfect circles over there, that's why. And then this one, I don't actually have to rate this. It's like Yeah, normal kit. So I'll give them 9 or 10. 9. Because these are good and these are like nice. Can you use them? Really nice. And these are also very good. I'm not much into poster painting, but still. So I'll give them 8. Yes. And then I have the plastic crayons here. These are 7 or 6 because they break really easy, really easily. And then there's water paints. I'll give them 7 or 8. I don't know. Yeah, because the opening is really small and they get finished really easily, especially when you're into really big paintings, water paintings. So yeah. And then charcoal pencils, I'll give them 8 or 9. Yeah, so because these are not the actual charcoal pencils, these work like charcoal pencils, but it does not actually give the real charcoal feel. And then there are these paints. I really like the colors and there's nothing wrong with them, so I'll give them 9.5 or 10, something like that. Glass paints, these are really good solvent, because they're solvent based, it's easy to fill in, and the medium provided helps a lot for lighter shades or shades where you have to, like, suppose you have to show bubbles or something, so it's really easy then here. And so I will give it 9 or 10, something like that. And here I have the pencils. I'll give them 8 or 7. Yeah, I like the other Camlin pack, the blue one. That those pencils are a little softer than these, because these are a little rough on the paper where you use it. So this is the pack, this is the old pack I used to use. This one. So yes. So that's it, I guess. I have this really good recommendation for this art clips. You should really use these clips for holding the paper where you, or holding the canvas even, where you're supposed to have to hold the reference when you're holding the canvas in your hand or when it is on the board. So yeah, do use this. And so we're done here. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. It's free. And do like it if you actually liked it. And recommend it to other art freaks who like and who are looking for some good art, art things. So thank you for watching. Bye-bye.